came and sang and blew everybody away.
He's been one of the most popular personality in the world. He's a planetary star.
He's a winner. I know he's gonna do whatever it takes to succeed, and I really believe that. Hopefully he will come back someday and pick up a mic and sing, but for now, he's the only person that can tell.
From child prodigy.
He came and sang and blew everybody away.
To international sensation.
Won't you help to sing?
Hello. Hi. How are you?
He is a face of activism.
Donc depuis longtemps, moi, j'ai toujours eu un intérêt par les écoles.
America, Sweden, England, love Africa.
Great.
And Senegal's political future.
He's a winner. I know he's going to do whatever it takes to succeed, and I really believe that.
He is Youssou Ndour.
Youssou was famous actually from day one. That's the special thing about him. I think he was like 13.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
Born in 1959, Youssou Ndour grew up in the middle class Medina district of Dakar, Senegal.
My dad did not want him to be a singer, to sing in a band, so he was hiding and was singing in like musicals back in the days. At a very young age, he was involved in a play and played the role as a young singer. That's how it started, really.
At the age of 13, Youssou joined Senegal's star band and quickly became a household name.
I hear a lot of stories, and actually one of them is pretty funny. He started singing in a band and actually took a trip to the Gambia. My dad called like the frontier, and the police chased him and actually made sure he came back to Senegal. On his way back to Dakar, he actually managed to sell his shoes and went back to the Gambia to perform. So that tells you how much he really wanted to be a singer. My dad, he doesn't joke, so I'm sure he got his punishment for sure. But that did not stop him. Maybe also that, made my dad understand that, you know, even though he was really young, he really wanted to do that.
Who said?
d'autres musiciens qui n'étaient pas du Star Band, parce que la moitié presque étaient des enfants de Gassé. Avait aussi commencé avec beaucoup de succès, jusqu'à ce que moi, je sente qu'il faut que j'aille de mes propres ailes. J'ai fait une réunion avec tous les musiciens de l'Étoile de Dakar pour leur dire que, bon, voilà, notre compagnonnage était très, très bien, mais bon, aujourd'hui, la porte était ouverte. Et comme ça, je pense que presque 70 ou 80% des musiciens ont décidé de venir vraiment faire partie de mon groupe. Et donc, le Super Étoile est né avec les cendres un peu de l'Étoile de Dakar. Donc, ce qui a fait une continuité et on a pris des raccourcis extrêmement importants, parce que si je devais commencer encore, ça allait être un peu plus difficile. Je pense que ça allait être un peu plus long.
I played bass with Étoile de Dakar for something like 1 year and a half. And after, when Youssou wanted to start his own band, he called me and I joined him again.
Le Super Étoile était parti du Mbalax, parce que quand nous sommes venus, la musique était entre la musique cubaine, latino, sénégalaise qui commençait à truc, et un peu de Mbalax timide. Mbalax, mais timide, un peu respectant les normes cubaines.
Super Étoile is a very strong band, a very tight band. We used to play together for so many times, and that's why I used to say that Super Étoile is the biggest band of the world.
Mon chanteur favori c'est Youssou, parce qu'il est meilleur chanteur. Je crois qu'il est l'homme idéal pour être le roi des chanteurs. Il est au top.
Au Sénégal, c'est Youssou.
Pourquoi?
Parce que depuis tout petit, il a été toujours un monument pour nous. Et puis, surtout pour la région de Saint-Denis, il a chanté.
Mon chanteur favori au Sénégal, c'est Youssou. Parce que je l'adore. Il chante des choses qui. Des chansons qui se réalisent. Il chante toujours des chansons du soir.
Youssou is a vocalist. Youssou is mind blowing. Youssou is a performer. I really believe that he's, you know, one of the greatest singers that we have in this world. It's the voice, it's the way he carries his melodies and how high he can go, how, you know, impressive his vocal performance is. Birima, which is a song that a lot of people like, and technically, it's a great song.
Birima, I love this song. Niwo Birima, fumuyendo mayendo fayendo na.
Fayendo nane. I think the reason why that song is really famous is because technically the way that Youssou sings that song is really impressive vocally.
In 1984, Youssou was propelled from Senegalese sensation to international stardom when Peter Gabriel spotted his talent. The duo went on to perform the smash hit In Your Eyes together.
Vu que par exemple quelqu'un comme Peter Gabriel s'intéressait à moi, ça m'a un peu parlé, ça m'a mis dans un milieu et peut-être d'espérer quelque chose parce que quand vous fréquentez une personne aussi connue, aussi impliquée, qui travaille énormément autour de ça, que vous soyez proche, vous ne pouvez qu'aspirer à évoluer vers lui. Et donc c'est là où j'ai eu le contact avec les maisons de disques. Travailler autour même des fois de certaines influences, mais pas trop.
In 1988, Youssou and Peter Gabriel teamed up again, performing at a concert in honor of Nelson Mandela's 70th birthday.
Mandela, il y avait deux importances. D'abord, je voudrais montrer au monde entier que le Sénégal était vraiment très préoccupé par la situation de l'apartheid et nous avons pu faire des choses et que les Sénégalais comprenaient vraiment l'histoire de l'apartheid. J'avais déjà, je l'ai rencontré pour la première fois, où il m'a dit merci pour ce que vous avez fait et tout.
This concert marked the beginning of Youssou's humanitarian legacy. Later that year, he performed with musical superstars Tracy Chapman, Sting, Bruce Springsteen, and once again, Peter Gabriel at the Amnesty International Human Rights Now tour.
I think that's one of the things that he kind of understood in the beginning, that you know, you don't really only have to be a great singer. You have to really use your position to make the world a better place.
Depuis longtemps, moi, j'ai toujours eu un intérêt par les écoles. Donc c'est dans les écoles que je vais faire des concerts, des playbacks et autres. Et je pense que c'est à partir de là où l'UNICEF m'a nommé ambassadeur. Et donc, alors, beaucoup plus conscient, beaucoup plus attentif, beaucoup plus rapporteur des choses que je vois. Et je me suis retrouvé vraiment intéressé, interpellé et activiste autour de ces choses humanitaires jusqu'à Amnesty International, la Croix-Rouge, toutes les situations. Donc il y a toujours eu des demandes, j'en prenais le maximum. Suivant mon travail, je me sentais bien et je ne sentais aucun problème pour faire passer ces messages-là et faire ce travail-là avec mon travail. Hi.
He is also the face of Malaria No More and led the Seek Sibiru or Fight Malaria song contest to help eradicate the deadly disease.
He's one of the people that put a lot of pressure on President Bush to put more money on the malaria fight.
If you never lived under the shadow of malaria, it's hard to imagine the toll.
It's like, how can we use the Youssou's impact and other actually, you know, fight malaria and, you know, t- talk about malaria and put malaria actually in the front of these big, you know, issues that these countries, you know, are actually fighting with.
Every child have the right to live a healthy life.
If you can write 1,000 songs and people know each and every lyrics of those songs, that means you can really communicate with the people. And that's actually, you know, in those terms that we actually started this campaign, which is still, you know, going. And I think, you know, now we are one of the major players in the fight against malaria.
But for all of Youssou's fame at home in Senegal and recognition as a humanitarian activist, it wasn't until the 1990s that his music took off internationally.
When the Supertrial was very, very famous worldwide, it was in 1994, after the release of The Guide. It was a song called 7 Seconds. 7 Seconds Away were really the trigger of everything. It was really a very good song.
Jusqu'au moment où on a enregistré la chanson 7 Seconds, qui a complètement changé tout, et on voyait comment une seule chanson pouvait basculer tout, basculer, c'est-à-dire ouvrir pour tout. Je pense que c'est en 93 quand j'ai enregistré 7 Seconds qu'on a donné à la maison de disque. Et qu'après ils commencent à dire, ah c'est un tube, c'est une chanson qui va être connue partout. Voilà, ils commencent à parler et effectivement on a vécu cela avec une chanson qui changeait toutes les donnes. Ouais, 7 Seconds, c'est en fait un message entre l'amour contre le racisme et les prétentions des uns et des autres. Donc je pense que c'est un peu une histoire, c'est pas une histoire triste, mais c'est une explication de la vie par déjà la naissance, par le témoignage, par le temps court aussi. Je pense qu'on a tourné autour des sons.
When we released the album The Guide with 7 Seconds. In every country in the world where we had the concert, the record company comes there to say, okay, you have a gold record here. When we came back from this tour, we had something like 10 gold records in our bags, you know. It's very, very powerful though. Yeah.
Over the years, Youssou has remained in Senegal, expanding his empire. He owns a nightclub, his own record label, radio station, newspaper, and television company, which employs hundreds of Senegalese, including his own brothers.
Donc je me suis dit que c'est le destin. Donc quand on vient de quelque part et qu'on a la possibilité, ce qui m'intéresse c'est le monde. C'est très bien et ma musique a besoin de ça, mon inspiration a besoin de ça. C'est là où j'ai ma famille, c'est là où j'ai mon histoire. Je vais pas mettre tout ça en stand-by et aller pour des raisons personnelles. Je n'ai pas besoin personnellement d'être dans une autre situation que cette situation que je vis qui est formidable pour moi.
Is it Senegalese? We are Senegalese, and nobody have to break the links from the motherland. Even if you're a good musician, if you go to settle down somewhere else in America or in Europe, you got to break the links to the motherland. You want to be able to sing the same way that your people sing. To make music so with the same taste.
I don't think Youssou would be Youssou Ndour if he had moved abroad. He understood that, you know, for him to be, you know, respected, he had to stay here and build his empire. And and that's what he did. I mean, people, it's the love of the country. He's always been somebody that loved his country and was really remembered.
In 2012, Youssou wowed the world by announcing his candidacy for president, running against two-term president Abdoulaye Wade.
He looked around and said, you know, there's nobody that I know or that I can trust to do this more than myself. So he decided to do that. But I think he really did that because he felt like it was time for him to be more involved, because, you know, people were kind of looking for leadership.
He wasn't happy of how politicians was taking care of the country. He thought that they were really doing politics for themselves, for their pocket or something like this. And he said, no, we must interfere in the political business because we have our word to say. We can't let politicians do what they want without nobody saying no. And I really agreed for that.
But just weeks before the election, Youssou's name was omitted from the ballot, and the typically peaceful country erupted into violence.
I think the government knew that it was too crazy to let Youssou Ndour run for president. That's how I say it. And they would definitely find a way to stop him, because, I mean, it's Youssou and he's the most popular person in the country. Thank God that did not stop him from moving forward, and I think he was a major player in the, you know, change that we just had in Senegal.
In February 2012, Macky Sall defeated Wade, becoming Senegal's fourth president.
Aujourd'hui, c'est la victoire du peuple sénégalais et je suis très fier d'avoir joué une partition parce que je ne suis pas le seul.
Ndour was appointed Minister of Culture and Tourism.
Donc là les vieilles qui sont là-bas.
Festival de jazz, quoi, je veux dire. Vraiment, cette année-ci, on l'a bien organisé, quoi, parce que la population, par rapport aux autres. Aux autres années qui étaient passées, bon, cette année-ci, bon, les Saint-Louisiens ont senti qu'il y a un festival de jazz ici, quoi. Vraiment, cette année-ci, bon, c'est OK, quoi.
He's a winner. I know he's going to do whatever it takes to succeed.
Ça va
If you open Time magazine and they say, okay, this Senegalese guy is among the 10 most influential people in the planet, that's tourism for me. I'm definitely, you know, confident that he's going to be the best minister that we ever had.
When the readers come and he get the Ministry of Culture and Tourism, I say, okay, he won't have many time to play music anyway. And you can't have two jobs here in Senegal because you can't be a minister and being a musician also. And so he had to make a choice. He made the choice.
Bon, aujourd'hui, moi, c'est y a qu'une seule chose qui compte. C'est d'aider le président de la République, M. Macky Sall, à réussir sa mission parce que c'est lui qu'on a élu. Il m'a fait l'honneur de me nommer dans son gouvernement, donc je vais l'aider pour réussir sa mission. Il n'y a pas autre chose.
Even a planetary star, musical star. So I think he can do a lot. He can give a lot for the tourism and in our culture. He can bring a lot for that.
Youssou is part of the atmosphere of Senegal, part of the country, part of the water, the culture. Youssou is just not a singer that you hear. It's part of this life for the last, you know, 30 years. What's next? That's the question I'm asking, like, who knows? I don't know if he's gonna run for president again. Who knows? As a music listener, as a fan, not as a brother, it's tough. I mean, sometimes I listen to the radio, I'm like, oh God, you know? It's tough, and I'm sure in his mind sometimes, you know, crosses, but Youssou's a genius. He will. Hopefully, he will come back someday and pick up a mic and sing. But for now, he's the only person that can tell.